Hey, you guys. Come on in. Come on in. It was my wife. I hate when my freaking...
It's the truth, it's so real, the way that it makes me feel.
Whoops. Welcome, you guys. Come on in, come on in. If y'all are new to the page, make sure you drop your name down in the chat so I can greet you properly throughout the live stream. Come on in, come on in. Shit, I see TikTok not sending my notifications out, but it's okay. It's fine. We gonna work with what we got. Did they block my other page? I don't have another page. Hey, beautiful. How are you, love? How are you? Come on in, you guys. I'm really not going to be long because I'm trying not to be long because I have to be up early tomorrow. And I didn't go to bed till like 3 o'clock last night. So, I need to make up on some Z's. Hey, lovely. Yes, I'm about to spill all the tea, how my week has been going. How have y'all been emotionally? How y'all been feeling? We're going to get into it, of course. But I did have some specifics that I wanted to talk to y'all about real quick because I'm going to kind of be going ghost. If you're not in a Patreon, then you're not going to hear from me for the next 3 to 5 days because this Cosmo energy gonna have me under a rock. We've been fasting all week. We've been, you know, getting our minds and getting our lives together. Like, y'all, I got a lot of manifest, okay? I don't know about y'all, but I got a lot to manifest, okay? So I've been in the grit fasting and praying, and in the Patreon we've been having a ball, like especially my VIP students, because you know I talk to them outside of social media, but we've been having a ball, from Bible study to just prayer warriors together. Like, it's been amazing. So if y'all not on the Patreon, y'all need to get in the Patreon because that's where I'm kind of migrating to. Like, y'all gonna see me less and less. I've been saying this for like the past year that I'm migrating to get off of social media. I want to do more work in the community, do more work in my communities, like the environments that I set online. So yeah, the Patreon is where it's at. It's only $5.99, y'all. It's only $5.99. So y'all definitely can get over there. But if you've been, the main objective to getting into Patreon was I have a hoodoo masterclass in there, but I'm also teaching y'all how to actually have a spiritual connection with the divine, like how to, you know, practice hoodoo to actually have a relationship with God and be able to work your magic without having to rely on anybody else, including myself. So I'm teaching you the medicine in the Patreon. And yeah, we have a family meeting coming up on Sunday where we're gonna be discussing the first plan that we did. Also, I want y'all to join me on the Bible app, but I'm not gonna give y'all my information till you get in the Patreon. But once you get in the Patreon, you'll be able to join me on the Bible app where we are doing like plans together, reading together, praying together, and things like that too. So if y'all looking for a little support group or whatever's for y'all to actually get into get in a godly relationship, like learning how to actually have a spiritual spiritual connection. Everybody want to be spiritual, but nobody really has a connection to the divine, and that's just crazy to me. So yeah, that's where y'all need to be at. But anywho's, how to get on the platform, the link is in my bio. So hop out of here real quick, go on to the link tree in the bio, and then it should be the first one. If I'm not mistaken, it's the first or second. For sure, the top three. For sure, the top three. But it's one of those. It's only $5.99. And y'all can come in and get the sauce as well. So what we're going to talk about tonight, I want to talk about the planetary shifts and everything that's going on. I'm not an astrologer, y'all. I say that all the time. But I do study my own natal chart, and I see kind of like what's going on when I'm reading my chart, like what's affecting other people as well. And then I see intuitively how it's been affecting the people that's been around, like the people that's in my community and things like that. So based off of what this week is looking like, we're going to discuss that and see how we should be preparing for this full moon. We got a super moon coming up in Capricorn. Y'all already know Capricorn energy is so intense. It's about, you know, discipline and order and structure and things like that. So that's a lot of the energy that's going on this weekend. Well, the next about 7 days, it starts today or either tomorrow. The first, I think it starts tomorrow on the first, and the actual full moon is on the third. So you got about a good week of using this energy that we're talking about. But it's gonna be some major energy, like it's gonna be some good old energy to be working with. So we're gonna talk about that real quick, and then we're gonna get some intuitive messages rolling. So yeah, if y'all are new here, welcome. I am Yinka, the owner and creator of my Snapshop, and I am a holistic healer where I focus on helping women balance their hormones naturally, but I also am an intuitive reader, psychic tarot reader, and I give you guys intuitive messages here on TikTok Live. So if that is something that you are interested in, stick around, set your intentions so that you can get your answers. I do not answer personal questions on my live streams or do personal readings on my live stream. It's always for the collective. But if you want a private reading, they're half off while I'm on TikTok. They're only $22. So it's only $22.22. So you can send your donations if you feel called to. If not, that's okay too, because my intuitive readings are kind of specific, so you might not even need a personal reading. So that's where we at. So how y'all feeling? Y'all get some shares up. I don't see how we got so many likes, and we got like, well, I don't know if we actually do got like three people in here or not. Yeah, I know they be playing with these numbers on this channel. That's why I don't be on TikTok like that, because they be doing the most for no reason. But yeah, how y'all feeling? How has y'all energy been this week? Y'all seen any enlightenment? Y'all had any aha moments, any epiphanies or anything like that? What's been going on this week? And I do have some notes here because I'm gonna get off of here at no later than 10 o'clock. So I do have my notes, so I don't be, y'all know how I run my mouth. Said grind time, for sure, definitely grind time, definitely time to be setting intentions and getting focused in on what do you actually want. It's just been, I'm getting through things, finding a new balance as things shift for me. Shame. How about me? Child. Honey. My edges was already on life support. They was already on life support, baby. Now, I'm about to pull the plug because it's over for them. This week has been, it's been very insightful. I've been fasting all week, first of all. Me and my students have been, and my mentor, I don't know if she did it, but I was doing it with, it was just originally just me and my VIP students. And we were fasting this week, just water fasting this week. And, then I told my mentor about it and she joined in too, but she's intentionally doing it this weekend. Anyways, this week I've been doing a lot of sitting out in nature, sitting out like all day long in the sun. And we in Texas, baby, so it's been hot. And I've been sitting out, I've been meditating, and I've been struggling. I'm not even gonna lie, y'all. I've been really, really struggling with being present. And I usually don't have a problem being present, but I've been struggling being present because I see my future, and my future is like so close, like it's like here, present is future, like it's all here, present. So I'm just like, I've been overwhelmed with, am I getting it right? Am I doing it right? Like, am I moving enough? Am I fasting enough? Like, not even am I fasting enough, but like, am I prepared? That's what I've been questioning. That's been my prayer all week. Like, prepare me, God. Prepare me for what you putting in front of my plate. Like, prepare me for it. Because the more that I try to take off of my plate, the more Spirit is giving me responsibility. And I'm just like, bro, like, I'm trying not to do so much so I can focus, but it's like, as soon as I take something off my plate, here comes somebody else who needs help. And it's not even something like I have a choice. It's just like, Spirit is like, yeah, go help them. Go lead this. Go join this community. And, you know, and give your, yeah, it's like, you know, everything is moving in divine order, but I'm just like, this is too much. It's too much. And I don't want to say that. I don't want to put that out there because it's not too much. It's what I've been asking for. It's what I was destined for. So it's not too much. So I've just been, my prayer has just been, prepare me. Prepare me and make sure that I'm ready. Make sure that, help me to feel ready. Because you wouldn't be giving it to me if I wasn't ready. So help me to feel comfortable. Help me to feel ready, because and right now I don't feel like I'm ready. Right now I feel like I'm gonna drown. And it is crazy because I don't feel like I'm drowning. That's the thing. Like, I don't feel like I'm drowning. I don't feel like, you know, I'm not efficient. I was gonna say effective, but I don't feel like I'm performing any less than I should be performing. Right, heavy on a crybaby moments, because honey, I was very, very emotional yesterday. Like, the past 2 days I've just been like crying, like, and it's like not even a bad cry, like I'm tired or I'm overwhelmed. Like, it starts off that way because that's what I'm trying to identify it with. Like, I just don't feel safe, I don't feel secure, and at the same moment, like, is in that same instance, like, you would think I'm schizophrenic if you heard my prayers out loud, because it's like, I'm so overwhelmed, I'm so sorry, I just feel like I'm not ready for this. And in the same time, is like gratitude, like, thank you so much for preparing me for this, thank you so much for trusting me with such responsibility, because, you know, God, just show me myself the way you see me. Show me the way that you see me. Give me your lens. Let me see myself through your eyes, because you must see me as goddamn Powerpuff Girl. Like, you see me as that girl. So help me to see myself like that, because I feel like I ain't ready. I feel like I ain't got there yet. And in that same moment, I'm just like, thank you, love. In that same moment, I'm just like, you know, God, I hear you. And they're comforting me, like, they're telling me, like, hey, everything is gonna be okay, everything, we're moving, like, we're flowing. And they're exposing the parts of me that doesn't feel secure. Like, y'all know, over the past month or so, I've been probably longer than that, like, I've been talking about help getting narrowed down on my schedule, like, getting a routine and sticking to my routine and getting organized and stuff like that, especially in business. Like, y'all know I've been struggling now for months, and I still feel like I'm struggling with that. And Spirit is just like, I don't need you to be perfect, I need you to just be consistent. Like, just keep doing it, whatever it is that I'm telling you to do. Keep going to your altar every day, keep making sure that you pray before you talk to anybody, or, you know, check any social media platforms. Make sure that you're in your devotion, make sure that you're nurturing your clients, make sure that you're nurturing your students. Like, just keep doing what you're doing. Don't stress yourself out about tomorrow. Don't stress yourself out about next month, next year. Continue to be focused on right now, and the discipline it takes to be in the present. And that's where I kind of been. You said, me too. I struggle with this so much. You say you love this for me. Thank you, babes. I love this for me too. Y'all, growing pains. Ooh, I see why people stay ignorant. Like, I will never, ever come out of my mouth again and say anything. Like, and I don't even say it often. I don't really say it at all. Like, unless it's like my sister or somebody, like somebody who close to me. But it's just like, what are you doing? But I really see why people stay stuck. Like, people stay doing the easy stuff. It's easy to go work a job for somebody. It's easy to live check to check and complain because everybody else is doing it around you. So it's easy to stay comfortable even though you're not comfortable. It's easy to stay there. And because it's hard, it's and I don't even like to say things are hard, to like speak it out there, but it's, I would be lying if I said it's anything other than challenging. Ripping yourself of your flesh and surrendering completely to God and saying like, bro, do whatever you want to do with me, like whatever that looks like, however you want me to serve you, just I'm here. It's hard. It's not easy. And this is why we need community. This is why we need support. This is why we have to change up our environment, because it's so easy. Thank God I don't really have friends like that. And the relationships that I've been building are like over the past year, everybody is in alignment with where I'm going. Because if I still had friends around me, my best friend that's still in North Carolina, like I haven't talked to her in months. And the last conversations that we were having, it was just starting to die off just off the strength of, you know, she's still on the same stuff. Like, oh, well, I'm gonna come out there and I'm gonna hit the club and stuff. Like, and we're not on that level. So it's just like, I'm so grateful that I'm not there. Like, I always had good discipline, but for people who surrounded by chaos, who surrounded by toxicity, who surrounded by people who don't care about upgrading themselves, just like to complain. Like, when you're surrounded by that, it makes it 10 times. So I've always been a loner. So I've never really been influenced by everybody else around me because I've always been a leader. So me being by myself, I thank God every day that I wasn't in, like when I was a child and wanting to fit in and stuff like that. I thank God every day for isolating me and never having me in rooms where everybody around me is like, I got a whole bunch of friends. You and I ain't never in my life had a whole bunch of friends ever. I've never had a lot of friends, and I'm so glad, because I don't even know if I would be able to sit here the way that I am now and be able to lead and be able to be as disciplined as I am right now had I had a lot of friends or a lot of influence around me, because this shit is hard and I don't got nobody else around me influencing me. It's hard, and I have the support around me. It's crazy, but it's hard, y'all. And I commend anybody who's on the journey. That's why I'm like, y'all gotta stop comparing yourselves to other people, because your journey is your journey, and you need to show yourself grace and be diligent on your journey, because it might take you years to get to where I am. It may take you might be further than what I am, and you thinking that you're not because you comparing it on different levels. Like, please stay in your lane. Please stay in your lane and prove yourself. Be in competition with the person you were yesterday. Please stop trying to be in other people's lane, because this shit is tough enough when it's just you against you. It's tough enough when it's just you against you. But you comparing yourself to somebody else. You comparing yourself to your parents. You comparing yourself to your siblings. You comparing yourself to somebody who's been doing this shit for 20 years and you just started 2 days ago. It's going to discourage you. It's going to make you feel like it's impossible. And I'm telling you, without all of that, it's already hard. So you're making it 20 times harder on yourself when you're doing all of that. We gotta stay focused on the journey, on the destiny, and on personal development. This is not a group project. This is not teamwork. This is you. The only teamwork you need to be working with your ancestors, baby. That's the only team you need to be focused on. That's the only team that you need to be praying with and worried about is your ancestors. That's it. That's all. Anything outside of that is going to cause you to lose your mind, or it's just going to cause you to stay stuck because you're going to get so overwhelmed that you just get paralyzed and not move. Okay? So, yeah, girl, that's where I'm at. Said they see it in you and on you. I say. He said the thief of all joy. Yes. Jealousy. Is it jealousy or comparison? The same thing. It's the thief of all joy. Please stop. Please don't do it, y'all. And I'm not, even if you're subconsciously doing it. Even if you're subconsciously doing it, because I used to catch myself doing that too. Like, I ain't never been a hater a day in my life. But I find myself, like, comparing myself to, like, my mentors. Like, oh, they telling me to do this or whatever. And I need to be able to do this. Or I need to, like, because I'm always trying to be the best at what I'm doing. So, they telling me I need to do this. If I'm not doing it perfect, it's like, I ain't doing it right. Like, what's wrong with me? I'm beating myself up. And it's just like, well, of course they could do it easy. You shouldn't be following them if they can't do something that they telling you to do easily. Like, but they got their own struggles too. I was literally just saying that to one of my students. Like, she was like, well, you seem super disciplined to me. Like, you always saying you lazy. You always like, but you be grinding. Like, you, I see you. And I'm just like, yeah, to the stuff that I'm telling you to do, I should be able to do that. You shouldn't be trusting me to do nothing other than what I'm telling you to do. But for me to be an effective leader to you, I have to be above where you are. Like, that's my comfort zone, the stuff that I'm telling you to do. I already mastered that. I wouldn't be teaching you if I didn't already know how to do that part. But these new doors that we walking into, that I'm leading you to as I go into, I got to be able to master that. So, yeah. Honey. We got some work to do this summer, y'all. And because of that, I have taken off for the month of July. I took off for June too, but I've still been doing a lot of work. But for sure, for the month of July, when I say straight spiritual grind, I'm not taking no one-on-one clients. Other than my spiritual clients, like if you're in the Patreon, like my VIP clients, those are the only people that I'm nurturing, because I'm on that path myself, so it's just easy to like work with them simultaneously. But when it comes to womb healing, I gotta take off, baby, because August is when the hormone challenge comes back around, and I'll be prepared in August to be able to do that. But for July, baby, I got a lot of work to do. But let's get into it, y'all. Let's get into it. I'm going to start with the cosmos and what's going on in the cosmos. And then we're going to pull some cards. And then I'm going to let y'all go, because I don't want to be here super long. Whew. Y'all take some of this ashe. Okay. This your favorite deck? I haven't used this deck in so long. I was like, let me go play with these. I stopped using it because they're so big, and it made me feel like I'm not shuffling good because I'm always dropping them. But anywho's, let's talk about Capricorn. This full moon being in Capricorn. So, from what I've seen in my chart and from what I've heard from, like, my astrologist, shout out to, Bahati Life, Jessica Alexander, that's my go-to astrologer girl. But, based off of that, this weekend, what you should be preparing yourself for is your discipline and your structure. That's what you should be preparing yourself for. Some of the things that you might see or hear this weekend is going to be based off of, like, what are your goals looking like? Like, what are some of the things that you want to manifest? And what does your daily work ethic look like? to actually obtain that? Like, are you actually working towards that, or is this just a dream? Like, are you actively preparing for what it is that you're saying that you want to manifest, or is it just a dream? That's what you should be focusing on this weekend. With this full moon, you want to release any limiting beliefs that you have that's hindering you from what it is that you actually want. Because when you look at your actual at your daily routine compared to your goals, or what you say you want as a goal, I want you guys to actually make a plan. Like, what in the next 90 days, what is something that you want to achieve? The next 90 days, not next year, not 5 years, because y'all kill me with these long ass goals. This 12 years away. What do you want to manifest and see here tangibly in the next 90 days? Ask yourself that, write it down. And be specific. What is it that you actually want? Like, don't be... The biggest part about manifestation that people overlook is the fact that you do not know what you want. It's like, oh, well, I just want a new car. What kind of car do you want? Like, a new car is new to you. That don't mean it's new off the lot. That don't mean that, you know, it ain't got... A new car could be a lemon. Like, what kind of car do you want? And it's, oh, I don't really care. Just anything reliable. Like, stop saying that you don't care, or stop trying to be humble or not specific about what it is that you want. Like, for one, it's a slap in the face to God when you're not specific, because it's like, you don't think that it can happen. You don't think that God can do it for you exactly the way that you want. Like, if you can see it, it exists. If you can see it, it exists. And if you envision it, and if you believe that there is a God, like if you have a higher source that you pray to and that you believe in, if you don't think that they're capable of doing this for you, for one, why is this who you think why are you praying to them? Why are you saying that this is whatever faith that you believe in, if you don't think that they could do something as small as bring something material into your life? And this don't even have to be material. It could be, you could be manifesting patience. You could be manifesting work ethic, or whatever the case is. Like, you could be manifesting things that are their character development and not just tangible things. Like, it don't matter what it is, but whatever it is, there's a source out here that's bigger than you, that's bigger than me, that's bigger than Orisha, that's bigger than Jesus, that's bigger than Muhammad, that's bigger than all of that, that can always conspire to give you exactly what it is that you want. So when you are saying that you will take anything, when you're saying that, oh, I don't have to be that specific, or I don't really know what it is that I want, the spirit is like, I don't know what you want either. So this is why you're not getting anything, because I don't know what you want either. You can take what you can get. Okay, well, I just want somebody, you want to manifest a relationship. Oh, I just want somebody who's nice to me. They don't got to have that much money. They don't have to have, they can have kids, like all the stuff. But you are saying all of these things based off of your fear that if you tighten up your boundaries, that it's going to be too hard to get. Let me tell you something. The harder it is to get, the bigger the reward of the glory that God gets. That's why I test God to the limits, okay? Everything I want is extravagant. Everything I want is over the top. If I feel like it's something easy and basic that I can get myself, it ain't big enough. I can walk outside and get somebody to be nice to me. I can walk outside and get somebody who got 5 baby mamas and just somebody to be in a relationship with. Anybody can do that. That's not hard to get. But when you go to say, oh, I don't want this, but I do want this, and I do, most of the time you don't even know what you want. You know what you don't want based off of the mistakes that you've already made. But what is it that you want? Be clear on what you want. What is it that you want? And if you don't know what you want, make sure that you're not setting intentions for anything until you get clear on what it is that you want. And let your intentions be to manifest what it is for your highest good in this moment, whatever that may be. Let you manifest the relationship that's for your highest good, that's going to teach you whatever it is that you don't know. Like, help me to have confidence. Help me to be courageous in my own self-confidence, my self-esteem. so that I won't keep getting the bare minimum. So that I think that I'm more valuable than just the bare minimum. Because a lot of y'all don't bring anything to the table, and you don't think that you have any value. That's why you're willing to take the bare minimum at your job, in your relationships, with your family discussions. You at Thanksgiving dinner and you letting your auntie talk to you all crazy or whatever, because you really do believe half the stuff that she's saying about you. We got to build some confidence. And so let that be your thing if you don't know what it is that you want. But you need to be clear on what do you want in this next season. In the next 90 days, what is it, something that's tangible that you want to see in the next few months? And then what is something that you need to do, or something that you need to actually obtain that? For example, I am manifesting a new residence, okay? I want to, but I'm not renting anywhere else. Like, I want to be a homeowner. I'm going to be a homeowner within the next few months. Y'all, I don't know nothing about buying no house. Nothing at all. But all of my friends are homeowners. So guess what? It ain't gonna be that hard. It ain't gonna be that hard. Guess what? I don't know nothing about doing all of that. My credit is not top tier or whatever. But do you think I care about that? Absolutely not. Why? Because my God is bigger than a credit score. You think I'm caring about, I don't got no money saved up to get no house. You think I care? You think that's gonna stop me from manifesting a house in the next couple of months? Absolutely not. Because guess what? My God is bigger than a closure fee or whatever. Like, whatever it is that I want, I am going to make sure that God gets the glory in making a miracle out of whatever it is that I want. Because that's how much faith I have in whoever I serve. That's how much faith that I have. I am not out here playing God small. I play small with myself, with the things that I think that I'm capable of. I'm gonna play very small because I might not got that much power. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just a little small fry. But when it comes to something that I'm asking God for, oh baby, I'm asking for the moon and my front door. Cause you say you big dog, right? You say I can move mountains, right? You said that I got you in me. So if I speak this, this should happen, right? If it's for my highest good. So that's the type of energy I want y'all to be on. That's the kind of confidence I want you to walk with, not on your own accord, but the fact that you have a source in you that you are connected to. And what I realized over the, like, since I've been in the Patreon and since I've been, you know, helping the women that I have in that group, like, get close to the guy, one of the biggest things that I noticed is that most people have no relationship with God, to God whatsoever. People might say a prayer to bless their food. That's about the only prayer that they say all day. And then you might pray at night. Oh, or when you wake up. Yeah, I doubt you're doing it when you wake up, because you'll have some clarity on what your day gonna look like. But you're not saying no prayers in the morning to start your day. You don't actually have a relationship with God. And even if you do pray, it's just like you're praying to the cosmos. Like, you're just praying to the planets. You're praying to the universe. That's not a relationship with God, y'all. And I'm all for the universe. I'm all for, you know, honoring the moon, cycles and phases, all of that. I appreciate and honor all creations. But that's not a relationship with God. Have you ever sat down and had a conversation with God? Have you had a conversation, or are you just on a one-way call, like you in prison or something? Like, hey, you put that on my books. All right, I see you later. That's what y'all conversations be sounding like. You ain't sat down and actually listened to nothing, because you don't meditate. So you don't know what God is saying to you. You just calling him up, complaining about some shit. You ain't even calling him up just to say thank you. You're calling God up just to complain about something, just to ask for something, and you've put in no work. You've appeased no spirits. You've given your ancestors nothing. You ain't giving God nothing other than what y'all talk about on social media. God is good. All the time, God is good. That's about the only praising you do. That's about it. But where's the conversation? Where's the intimate relationship that you have with God? Where is that? It doesn't exist. And this is why your life is chaotic. This is why you feel like you're confused and you don't know whether to go left or to go right. This is why you feel like you don't have no guidance and you're just out here winging it with life. You shouldn't have to wing it. You should know exactly what your next move is based off of who's telling you where to go. You shouldn't be doing anything without intention. You shouldn't be applying to no jobs without intention. You shouldn't be being in a relationship. When I say every single thing I do is with intention, if I got a date with somebody trying to holler at me, I'll get back at you later. Give me your number. I might call you. And what you think I'm doing? I'm going to say, is this worth my time? I'm about to, you know, cast a little bit, throw a couple shells or whatever. Is this person for my highest good? Is going on this date for my highest good? It's really that simple when you actually have a relationship with a source that's bigger than you. But when you're out here trying to move on your own flesh, on your own mind, this is where you're going to end up, in chaos, in confusion, because you as a little human don't know shit. You don't know nothing. Your flesh is leading you, not your higher self, because your higher self is connected to God. So if you don't have a relationship with God, you don't have a relationship with your highest conscious. And when we're talking about your destiny was already predestined for you before you were born. So if you're not on track with that, that's why your life looks like turmoil. And I don't want y'all to don't mistake just adversity, like God challenging you to stretch you to help you to grow. Don't mistake that with you not being in alignment. And sometimes we do that. We do that a lot, thinking that we're not on the right path because we're getting challenged with things. And that's something when you have a relationship with God, you know the difference between that as well, because they're going to consistently show you, hey, you're on the right path. They're going to continue to give you signs that you're in alignment, that everything is going okay. This is just a test. They're going to keep showing you those things. But when you don't know what God sounds like, what the messages look like what the omens and signs, what they mean, you're going to always think, well, what am I doing wrong? What am I doing wrong? I thought I did this. I started praying. Oh, baby, that's when the shit gets started. That's when the fun start. When you actually start going on the right path, that's when you get hit the whole kitchen countertop top thrown at you. Baby, it don't get easier. It don't get easier. It does not get easier. It is much easier. Just think of how fucked up your life was. I don't know where y'all come from, but I'll just say for me, being a broke college student, you know, doing everything on my own, never being an outcast in my family, like always being by myself, all of that, like just thinking of the worst case scenarios and all the everything in between with me just doing dumb shit my whole life. All of that is still easier than being righteous and walking with purpose, walking with intention, following God, surrendering to, like, all of that is easier. Living check to check, being miserable, being in toxic relationships, you know, all of that was easier. All of that was easier than what I'm doing right now, and the woman that I'm becoming, the growing pains that comes with this. All of that was easier. So if you don't want, if that's too much for you, I encourage you to stay. I encourage you to stay. If you're comfortable there, stay there. Please stay there, because it's not easier over here. It's not easier walking away from everything that you know. It's not easier, you know, being an example and being a leader and having blood on your hands because you ain't correcting people around you. It's not easier having to see and know everything. Like, it's not easier being convicted for every time you do something that you're not supposed to do. Like, and you're convicting yourself. It ain't nobody else telling you to do it. It's easier. It's easier to stay in the dark. It's easier to stay in your flesh. It's easier. You gonna pay for it, for sure. But it's easier. It's much easier. But the reward is so much better once you cross over. It's also very much so beautiful to not have to stress out about bills. It's beautiful to not be around people who don't really care about you, who envious of you, who want to see you fail, who just sit around drunk, broke, and depressed all the time. It's so much beautiful to be at peace. But it's a price to pay to be at peace when you're so far in the trenches. When you're so far in the trenches, you gotta pay a lot of dues to get over here because you've done so much on that end. Karma don't miss a beat. You can choose to bring yourself back, but depending on how far you done got down out there in the world, baby, you still gonna have to pay all of that back to get to a place of harmony, to get to a place of peace. Healing all that trauma that you done built up over that time. Like, oh, it's easier to blame people for your trauma. It's easier not to take accountability. It's easier. But when you the only person in the mirror, like, when every sentence, you can't even get mad at people. Imagine not even being able to get mad at somebody who done stabbed you in the back because you just got to pray for them. You just got to pray for him. You feel sorry for him because, like, damn, you that miserable? You hurting that bad? You that bottled up inside, burned up inside, that dry inside that you got to move like that? You can't even get mad at people. You got to still move with love. It's not easy. It's not easy when you fighting ego against spirit. It's not easy. But hey, the next part of this trying to make sure we on the same page. I ain't trying to go into, y'all know spirit be moving. It's that me either, and I'm doing the same faith goddess. Ashe. Right. Talk to him like you know him. Y'all don't know him. Y'all just be on the hotline. On the hotline. But yeah, so the next, that's what you should be expecting for this Capricorn full moon. The Capricorn full moon, you should be releasing all of this. And it sounds cliche every single time we hear about full moons or whatever, release what doesn't serve you or whatever. But I want y'all to really be intentional about what doesn't serve you. Like, it's some things that you know don't serve you. You know you shouldn't be eating a certain way. You know you shouldn't be drinking and getting high and, you know, doing all the other stuff. You know those things. But when I'm saying release the things that don't serve you, release mindsets that don't serve you. Like, what belief systems are you still holding on to that you really don't believe in anymore? It could be religion. It could be, you know, your thoughts on marriage. It could be a lot. That's one of another things that I'm working on right now. Like, that spirit is like transforming in like my mental behind marriage. Like, I've never wanted to be married. That's never been one of my things. Like, I don't even prioritize like romantic relationships, but spirit is like, you're going to be married. Like, and I've been known that anyways, because they've been trying to get me married since I was like 23. But like, it's like, now I am becoming the wife, like becoming the woman that desires marriage, for one. Like, that's my mind around that is being transformed, because I gotta want it to actually get it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, even though I've been known that it was in my charts, the same thing with children. Like, I don't care if I have children or if I don't. I mean, do if I don't, but I already knew that I was destined to have kids. So it's just like, now I have to, I'm being molded into the person that actually wants it. So it's just not like something else that I'm doing, but something that I desire. So something that I can have and actually obtain in a holistic way, in a righteous way, that I don't feel like I'm forced, or it don't just happen reluctantly. So yeah, what is it that, what beliefs that you do you need to get rid of? What belief systems are not working for you anymore? It could be something that your granny didn't been saying and passing down for generations that does not serve you anymore. Let's change those ideologies, or at least ask God to bring it to the surface. Ask God to show you the parts that are hidden from you. The parts that are in your subconscious right now. Like, we're still fasting up until Monday, which is when the actual full moon is. We're fasting, doing 12-hour fast, so from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. But y'all can jump in on that too if you just want to do a water fast for 12 hours a day for the rest of the weekend, or the whole time that the moon phase is here, so up until Wednesday of next week. Feel free to do that fast, and during that fasted time, make sure that you're focused on spirit revealing to you what it is that you need to let go of. It might be your ego. It might be your relation, your relationship with money. It might be your relationship with love. Like, what are the belief systems that you have adopted from your environment or from your experiences that you need to let go of? What spirits on you specifically? I was just talking to my Baba last night, and he was saying that they had did an Ebo about releasing spirits that no longer serve you, as in spirits that we've conjured up over the years. And he used the example of let's say you was in school and you done conjured up this, like, you used to get bullied all the time, and you've conjured up this spirit that either like when you feel threatened, or you feel like somebody is intimidating you or trying to bully you, you got this demon spirit on you that just like bucks, and now you angry, and it makes you want to fight. Or that spirit might be the spirit of, you know, like a trickster spirit, where you want to get back at people, like you real petty in that way when somebody's doing something to you, or you feel offended by something. That might have worked for you then to help you survive through high school or college or whatever, but is now, as a grown ass woman, like, you still acting like that. You still, anytime you get offended by something, you going off out on the wall, you trying to get back at somebody, you trying to ruin their life. That doesn't serve you anymore. It served its purpose back then, but it don't serve you no more. So you need to ask God, like, what parts of myself do I need to, what needs to be revealed? If you don't know specifically, what parts of myself do I need to let die right now? What spirits do I have on me that I need to let go of, that need to, you know, be buried and away from me because it's not serving me anymore? You want to be specific on that, because this full moon is going to be catered to your behaviors, your consistency, and that's what manifests things. Like, how most people are not good ritual people, like, as far as spell work and stuff like this. This is why most people call you, like, for myself as a practitioner, this is why most people call me to do their spell work for them. Because I'm the type, I'm gonna teach you how to fish. I'm not too keen on, you know, giving, like, doing stuff, because that's more work for me. And I got too much shit to do anyways. So I'd be more so like, book a consultation and I'll tell you what you need to do. But people don't want to do that because they know they're not gonna be consistent with it. But you want the divine to work for you. You want these spirits and these energies to work for you. You want your ancestors to work for you, but you're not willing to give them 10 minutes a day to start your day. You're not willing to give them no fruits or a piece of damn spaghetti when you cook. Like, you're not willing to give nothing to these energies, but you want so much from them. We got to get out of that selfish mentality, especially when we're working with bigger entities than ourselves, like, other than the human force. Like, y'all, these human relationships are very so minute when it comes to your connections and your network. Like, that your network is all right. But when you got a network in the spiritual realm, when you got people or energy on outside of the physical realm that's working and moving for you, that's the flex. That's the flex, because that shows how much discipline you have when it comes to serving something. Like, when you can serve your ancestors at an altar every single day, when you can serve and feed them and consider them, it's going to be easy for you to serve and feed your community. It's going to be easy for you to serve and feed your family. It's going to be easy for you to serve and feed your relationships, your spouse, like, your friends. Like, when you already come from a place of servitude, like, because that's all this is. People want all the status, and people want all the, oh, you look so disciplined, you look like you got all of this, baby. Guess what I do all 90% of my day? I'm helping other people. I'm not receiving things most of the time. I give out way more than I receive, way more energy than I receive on a daily basis. But most people don't even want to give a little bit. You don't want to give to the people that you do have around you. You selfish in your relationships. I ain't about to do that. It's 2023. We ain't about to be, I ain't about to be no slave to him. He can fix his own food. He can do all that. Like, y'all not even, you're selfish. And if you're selfish with the people that you can see, the good book says, how can you say you love me and you hate your neighbor? You hate your brother. Me that you ain't even seen. You hate your brother. You treat your brother shitty and you say you love me? How is that possible? How is it possible? And it's not about just doing stuff just because. Like, it's not. Why do you want a reward for every little thing that you do? Oh, I did that for you. This the least you can do. This the least you can do. Like, bro. It's the entitlement for me. It's the entitlement for me. Because how much do your ancestors do for you when you ain't even put them out a plate of watermelon before? You ain't even put, all you do is pour little libations out and you pour it out for your homies. You don't even pour that shit out for your granny. Your granny like gin too, baby. Your auntie like want a pack of smokes too, baby. Well, you pouring it out to your homie. You better pour it out to somebody who actually working for you in your bloodline. The people who protecting you. That's who you better be pouring it out to. But I digress. Hey, baby. Okay, so the next planetary alignment right now that we have this weekend, or I think it starts tomorrow, or maybe it started today, but Neptune is retrograde in Pisces. So Neptune talks about your dreams, your visions, and unconditional love. So it's about your relationships, but like unconditional love. So it's not necessarily like romantic relationships or specific relationships, but just love in general. It could be your unconditional love to yourself. So dreams, visions, and unconditional love. So during this time, what you should be seeing with it being in retrograde, for one, it's been direct since December, if I'm not mistaken, December 2022. So look at the events that's happened up until December, up until today. What are some of the things that happened in your life? And whether it's big or small, just kind of go over the events that's happened, some of the epiphanies that you had. And then you want to go and actually find the truth in certain situations, like in your relationships, in your communication with people. Like, go and find the truth of whatever it is that's happened over the past 6 months. And what this is going to do is give you clarity and give you vision, like get clear your vision to actually get a real perspective of some of the things that has happened. You might have heard some good news and it's like, okay, do I want to believe this or do I not want to believe this? During this time, you should be able to see the truth of the matter. You should be able to see things with a clearer mind, not with emotions, but a clear logical mind. Like, okay, well, now I see this is what that person meant, or that wasn't even true at all. Like, but this is the truth, because things can be true, but that doesn't mean that that is the truth. That is, it's two different things. Like, when something is true, it's true that I am, you know, in Texas right now. Like, that is true, but that is not a truth, because I could be in New York tomorrow. I could be in Africa tomorrow. That is not a truth. The truth cannot be changed. Something can be true and not be a truth, if that makes sense. So you want to be looking for the truth of the matter, not what's true about it, but what is the truth in the situation. That's what you want to focus on during this time. And then how can you connect with your intuition as your vision is getting clearer, as your dreams are going to get really amplified. So if you know about dream work or anything about dream work is very important. Like, this don't have to necessarily be during a full moon or anything like that, but dream work is very important, because this is where spirit works the most, in your dream, because that's your subconscious level. Like, that's the time where they can, you know, that's when the higher ups or whatever, they're playing free, because you're not here in the physical, so you're on that dimension. So you want to always be very mindful of your dreams in general, but right now your dreams should be getting very clear, especially if you are setting intentions. So I don't know why this happens for me, but I get more dreams. Like, my dreams are more vivid when I'm not focused on it. Like, say if I'm focused on something throughout the day, I'll dream about it. But if I, like, try to go drink my tea or whatever, Give me some mugwort tea, some chamomile, some lavender, some valerian, and, you know, all the sleepy time teas. And then I'll go to sleep with an intention of something like, hey, show me this in my dream. I won't remember nothing in my damn dream. But when I'm not focused on something specifically before I go to bed, but I'm focusing on it, my intention is about it throughout the day, I'll get answers through my dreams, if that makes sense. That's just for me. You can try going to sleep and setting your intentions before bed too. Whatever works for you, you got time. So just be intentional on throughout your day. Like, what are you thinking on when you're conscious? That's the reason why I believe it works like that for me. What I focus on when I'm conscious is more important. Right before I go to bed, I'm not really giving energy to it. I'm just like, okay, well, maybe 20 minutes of meditation or whatever, and then I'm going to bed. That's not an intentional focus. But if I've been focusing on something all day long and I just go to sleep, like, with the intention of show me what I need to see or whatever the case is, most of the time I don't even say nothing about that. I just thank God for my day and, you know, whatever else. But that's when I actually get answers, when I'm thinking about it at night. I mean, when I'm thinking about it throughout the day. The next thing is, during this time, you're going to be able to see, hey, Kadira, I haven't seen you in forever, love. How you been? The next thing is fantasy versus reality. This is what the divine is going to be showing you as well. Like, and when I say fantasy versus reality, I'm talking about, again, that truth factor. What is the truth? Not what is true in this moment, but what is the truth about your dreams versus your reality. Is there a way that you can bring your dreams to a reality on a practical level? This is that fantasy versus reality type of mindset when it comes to manifestation. Like, are you really manifesting, or are you just having dreams because you don't, they're not goals, they're just dreams because you don't have a plan to go to it. Like, you don't have a logical plan. You're just like, oh, well, I'm just going to wake up a millionaire because I really, really want to be a millionaire. And you think you want to be a millionaire, but your subconscious is like, girl, you don't want to be a millionaire. You ain't doing nothing that's millionaire. Like, you ain't doing nothing that, whatever, you ain't around people who are millionaires or anything to be a part of that energy. You just saying something just to be saying it. Like, so that's the fantasy mindset. Where the reality is, yes, I want to be a millionaire. I've also surrounded myself with millionaires. I'm going to more events. I'm trying to be more business savvy or, like, more political when it comes to, like, you know, financial, what's it called? Being more financial literate and things like that. Like, are you looking more into investments? Are you having a more of a wealth mindset? Are you getting more into stocks and things like that? Like, things that wealthy people talk about, like, that's a reality. That's aligning to wanting to say that you want to be a millionaire or you want to make six figures or whatever your goals are. That is more so a reality. So reality versus fantasy, and what is the truth in between that? The truth is, you might just be playing with yourself. You might just be pulling bullshit out your ass just to say you're doing something or because it sounds good. Everybody like to be a dreamer. I ain't knocking you from dreaming, but that's a fantasy, and you need to know the difference between the two. And some people are really, really, really truly believing that they're manifesting things, or believing that, oh, well, I prayed really hard about this, or I really, really wanted it, and you really, really didn't, and you don't know the difference. But during this time, ask God to show you, is this practical? Show me the plan to get this goal, this dream to a actual reality, to bring it to my reality. Show me the things within myself that needs to change for me to get to this reality. Prepare me for this inheritance that I'm asking for. Prepare me for this marriage that I'm asking for. Prepare me for this community that you're wanting me to lead. Asking for preparation for whatever it is that you're looking for, because that's where the magic is going to happen. That's where the transformation is going to happen. And then the balance between the two, the balance between God, you know, stripping you, okay, well, you said you want to do this. Now, if I'm telling you can't spend no money, if I'm telling you you need to budget, if I'm telling you need to do this and do this, the sacrifices that are required for you to actually step into this, are you willing to actually balance that? Are you willing to take away your ego, take away your flesh, your fleshly desires, like your cravings for things that are low frequency, or your cravings for things that are not in alignment for where you think you want to go? Like, are you willing to try to balance that? Are you capable of balancing that right now? Do you have the resources? Do you have the tools? Are you equipped to be able to balance these things? If not, you know what you got to ask for. And if you don't know, Spirit is going to start to show you that during this time anyways. Because you can't unhear what I'm telling you. So you're going to subconsciously already be programmed to ask yourself these things, whether you know it or not. But you're going to start to see those things. So, like I said, I was talking to my baba last night. And he was saying, like, when he did the ritual to release these energies, these spirits that no longer serve him and things like that, or, you know, the Ile in as a whole, like, when he was doing this ritual, the next day or later on that day or whatever, he was like, he had snapped on somebody, like he, you know, was coming out of ego or something with whatever situation. And he was like, that was Spirit bringing that to his attention. Like, this is the thing that you want to let go of. Let me show you the part. Let me show you the spirits that are in you that you need to let go of. The same thing actually happened to me this week as well. So I've been becoming a Proverbs 31 woman. I'm becoming a modest woman. Okay. That don't even sound right coming out of my mouth. But as y'all can see, like, I got auntie nails and everything. Like, I cut down my grippers. Like, you know, we trying to get a little bit more modest and things like that. The only reason why I'm showing a little skin is because I just took a shower. But, you know, that is the woman that I'm becoming, right? That's the woman that I'm becoming. So as I was, you know, saying those prayers and doing that work to release the Jezebel spirit in me, to release any spirits of, you know, familiar spirits, any spiritual husbands or whatever I got that's causing me to stay the way that I am, when I'm releasing all those spirits this week. And y'all, it's been almost 2 years since I didn't had some, okay? But this week, I have been, like, super, like, distracted with lust. Like, wanting to get some. Like, I've just been, like, super. And I had hid all my toys. Like, I put them up and everything. Because I'm just like, I'm going to seriously be celibate. Like, I'm seriously, like, no arousals whatsoever. I'm just going to use this energy to just focus on my creativity and things like that. But when I say I was struggling with that for, like, the past 2 days, like, and I'm like, bro, where the fuck is this coming from? Like, I'll never be like that. But that spirit bringing that up out of me and seeing, like, okay, do you want to give into it? Are you going to give into it? Or are you going to break that spirit off? Because you saying you want to give into it. You saying you want to get rid of it. But when I bring it out of you, you going to feed it? You telling me that you still want it. So are you going to feed it? Or are you going to actually, you know, kill it off and let it be? Like, by actually turning it into something else, right? So, yes. And this goes to the last thing is, two more things, with this Neptune energy is addictive behavior. So anything, this all goes back to kind of the same thing, any addictive behaviors that you might have. This could be sexual behaviors. This could be drug behaviors. This could be food behaviors. Like, what are you addicted to? What is it that got you in a chokehold that you cannot put down? Most people in America are addicted to food. That's for one, especially sugar. Most people are addicted to it. And then we got most people are addicted to, right after food, would be a substance abuse. Whether it be alcohol. If you can't go out with your friends without drinking, without getting a bottle, without ordering a drink at the table, then you most likely have an addiction to the social life. Because people are like, oh, I'm just a social drinker or a social smoker. It don't matter. Can you go out and be social without doing it? It's still an addiction if you can't. Right? So looking at all of your addictive behaviors and breaking those behaviors, like, it doesn't matter what it is. The only addiction you should have should be the addiction to spirit. You should be addicted to praying, addicted to meditating, addicted to leveling up, addicted to setting goals and achieving them. Those are the only addictions you need to have. Anything that you are addicted to that's taking you away from your higher self, you need to be focusing on those things and intentionally trying to release them. And then the last thing is retreating. So this is a time, being that this full moon is a super moon, this is a time where you want to disconnect. Like I said, I was making sure that I came on live tonight, even though, you know, we know we come on Fridays, but I was like, let me not miss this Friday because y'all not gonna see me on no social media. Like I'm deleting this app as soon as I get off of here until I'm done with my fast. So y'all probably won't see me till like Tuesday unless you're in the Patreon. Deleting Facebook, deleting YouTube. I'm not gonna be on any social media platform until, other than Patreon, until probably like Tuesday or Wednesday, because I am probably Wednesday, because I'm very, very intentional, and I have like my emails and stuff. I'm doing, well, my email's not social media, but I'm making sure that I am focused on like while I'm fasting for them 12 hours first thing in the morning, like 12 hours straight. When I say I'm not playing, your girl is about to be a homeowner. And y'all mark my fucking words. Your girl is about to be a homeowner. And I'm telling y'all right now, I don't have no money saved up for this. And my credit score is like a 630. But I'm telling y'all, within the next few months, I'm going to be a homeowner. And it's because I'm not playing about my manifestations. I'm not playing. Like, this is the work that don't nobody want to do to get to their goals. Where y'all be seeing people like, oh, well, you're just lucky. Or, of course you can do it because you got the money. Like, I'm telling you, I don't got the money. I don't got the qualifications to get none of this shit done. I'm getting it done because my spirit team is getting it done. I don't got nothing. I don't got nothing. All I got is sacrifice. All I got is obedience. Whatever it is that God want me to do to be able to get this, that's what I'm doing. That's all I got. I ain't got no money to sacrifice. Okay, let me sacrifice my life. Let me sacrifice my food. Let me sacrifice my time. I don't got no time to give to no social media. I don't got time to give to no distractions. I gotta be focused day in, day not out, at the altar, at the crossroads, at the trees, outside, at the railroad tracks, praying, fasting, meditating, praying, fasting, meditating. That's what your life gotta look like. If you're wondering what's required of you to be magnetic, if you're wondering what's required of you to be so favored, to be so blessed, when y'all be looking at people and just like, oh, well, they're so this and they're so that, this is why you could tell who praying and who not. This is how you can tell who praying and who not. When you're able to stop the world, and give honor to God, stop the world and give honor to your ancestors and create a world around them being the priority, because none of that matters. None of this stuff matters. None of this at all matters. Your job don't matter. Your school don't matter. Your children don't matter. Nothing matters other than your relationship with God as your own spirit having an assignment. Nothing matters but your relationship with God. Nothing in your life is going to work for you unless you have a relationship with God, period. So if you can't shut the world down to get the answers that you're looking for while you out here asking God and pleading God and begging God to move something for you, move for yourself and shut everything else down. You can't ask for something and still doing the stuff that's in the way of your blessing. You asking God to help you build a relationship with somebody that God don't even want you with. Nobody even told you to be with this person in the first place. And you think you're going to get a blessing for it? God, help me with this relationship. God, like, no. I keep making a nigga fuck you over so you can leave him alone. You talking about bless it? No. I'm not going to bless it. I'm going to keep hurting you. I'm going to let them keep tearing you down. I'm going to let them keep giving you BV. I'm going to let them keep giving you STDs. I'm going to let them keep putting babies in you and not taking care of them. And while you keep still being stupid, until you decide to shut the world down and find a relationship with me, you're going to keep getting turmoil. You're going to keep falling behind. You're going to keep feeling chaotic. You're going to keep feeling like you can't trust nobody, including yourself. You're going to keep gaining weight. You're going to keep being sick. You're going to keep being unhappy. You're going to keep feeling unfulfilled. It don't matter how much money you make. Until you decide to put everything down and say, okay, God, you wrote the blueprint. You're the manufacturer here. How do I work this thing? What am I supposed to be doing with my hands? What am I supposed to be doing with my voice? Who am I supposed to be speaking with? Where am I supposed to be going? Guide my feet. Guide my mind. Guide my heart. Guide my womb. Protect me. Until you go to the person who created you, we're going to always be here having these same conversations. Okay? So, I done talked way over the time I need to talk. I don't even think y'all need no cards. But I'm going to pull a little quick read. We're going to pull a couple little something. Just to see what's the goal. I mean, what's the mood. But how y'all feeling? What's tea? My throat is dry. How y'all feeling? Where y'all at? Where y'all at? Where is y'all at? Like, damn, how many twists is it? I didn't mean literally, but hey, from Birmingham. I mean, mentally, where y'all at? Where you, how y'all feeling right now? If y'all want personal readings, y'all better go ahead and get them. Or go ahead and book them. Because it's the perfect timing. I love doing readings when I'm fasting and stuff. Because they be so on point. They be on point anyways. But they just be so on point. They be so vivid. And they be so spot on. Especially with stuff that's going on. So this is a perfect time. Perfect time for y'all to get intuitive messages if y'all need some. And also make sure that y'all join the Patreon so y'all don't miss next week's gems. Hey, Rebirth Society in the building. You said I've been feeling good mentally. So glad I caught this live. I'm so glad you did too, love. Said gave back to the trees today. Yes. I love it. Y'all, I cannot wait to move. I cannot wait. I got to get back to the city, y'all. I'm in the goddamn trenches, okay? I'm not in the trenches. I'm in the boondocks. I ain't in the trenches now. Let me go back. Because we ain't in the hood. We just in the country. So, ready and excited about the hormone challenge. Yes! I can't wait to this hormone challenge too, because y'all gonna get a new version of me, because we doing so much work. Yes, you can send it to the Cash App. Make sure you have your email address in the for section, your email address, so that I can send it to you via voicemail or voice clip to your email. But yeah, this hormone challenge is gonna be so dope, because y'all gonna get a whole nother version of me. I don't even know what this hormone challenge is gonna consist of, because I'm gonna be a whole new bitch by the time we start. So every time I level up, y'all always get the benefits of it. It don't matter what, whether it's a hormone challenge or, you know, whatever I'm doing, y'all gonna always get the benefit of it, because I've leveled up. So yeah, I don't even know what to expect. I don't even know what to expect, like, in the hormone challenge. But I know it's gonna be better than the last one and the one before that and the one before that, because I'm gonna be a whole nother person. Thank you, babes. I love to hear it. But yeah, this hormone challenge is going to be dope. And the retreat is going to be even better, because we're going to be in Colorado. We've been doing a lot of retreating, honey. We're going to be doing a lot of retreating. Because y'all, also, we're doing a spiritual retreat in March. Don't forget. We're doing a spiritual retreat out in March, March of 2024. Me and my mentor, we're doing a spiritual retreat. And this is, it don't have nothing to do with hormonal imbalances or anything. Yes, it's collective love. This is spiritual growth, spiritual healing. We're healing trauma. We're doing a lot. We're doing some ayahuasca. We're doing a lot. It's a 7-day retreat in Costa Rica. If y'all don't know, get into it. And y'all, excuse me. Excuse me. I think we got like 6 spots left. Yeah, but everything is inclusive. The link is in my bio for that as well to apply for it, because everybody can come. We want to make sure that everybody is on the same energetic level. Make sure it's in your budget. It is an investment, but that's why I say I want y'all to go ahead and apply for it and go ahead and start, so you can make your payments on it. I think we end payments at, your total balance got to be done by like February 3rd. But yeah, it is an investment. I'm not going to lie. But everything is included, including your flight. Including your flight. Your flight is going to be taken care of as well, to and from. But the reason why I do it like that is because I don't want people landing at 3 o'clock and 1 o'clock and 5 o'clock. I want us all to land within the same hour and make sure, even though we all over the country, like, I want to make sure everybody is landing around the same time so we can all go together where we're going and all of that good stuff. So yes, please go look at that. Please go start making y'all payments on it. Y'all got plenty of time. What is it, like 9 months? Y'all got like 9 months to pay that off. But yeah, this is gonna be a very healing retreat, like very healing retreat. Okay. Woo. I feel tight, y'all. I'm sorry. I need to hurry up. Girl, you talk too much. I need to get in the bed. Together forever. 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 Okay, y'all. Whew. I just seen a yellow bird. A yellow bird. I don't think I've ever seen a yellow bird before. I don't know what that means, but somebody can look up what's the sequel. What are some type of yellow birds? And what's the significance? The spiritual benefits of it? I see a red ribbon. Somebody has like a red ribbon on their this is some hoodoo shit. But somebody got a red ribbon on their rear view mirror. Or they may need to put a red ribbon on their rear view mirror. This is a protection spell. If you drive for a living, like you might do Uber or DoorDash or something like that, or something like where you on the road all day, you might need to put a red ribbon on your rearview mirror. A half an inch thick red ribbon. Tie it like a bow. I'm seeing his yellow bird again. It's like a baby chick. The first one wasn't a baby, though. This seems like a family member, a relative that's like an ancestor. Let's see what cards we have. Oh, it's a lot going on. Ain't nobody feeling like you. Okay, so a yellow bird means joy, happiness, new beginnings, and transformation. Mm-hmm. That makes sense. Okay, so what we have right now, and I don't know why spirit just, like, the way I have these are kind of, like, split. But we have the Queen of Cups on one side. Queen of Cups. The Two of Swords. The World card. And the Hermit. And I'm going to break these down like how I see, like how they have them split. So I guess this is two different messages. Get down. So with this, the first message, this is definitely somebody struggling with tapping into their emotions, like, or they're feeling all of the emotions right now. But you might be somebody who's just like, you think you have this hard exterior, you try to have this tough exterior on the outside, but you're softening up by nature, and you're softening up because spirit is like bringing all this trauma to your bringing all this trauma to like the forefront of your, like, this is the reason why you act this way. This is a secluded time. Again, this still piggybacks off of the message that I was giving earlier about retreating, because with the Hermit here, like, spirit is like, I want you to deal with all of this in, like, by yourself, but I don't want you to a lot of people, when they think they're healing because they're doing it in the dark, and then they get out into the light and or into the real world, and it's like, oh well, I thought I healed from this. Like, you still have to apply it to the real world. You still have to get out. But spirit is saying, like, right now you need to be in isolation so that you can know what's yours and what's not. Some of you are empaths. Like, you literally are empaths, and you don't know how to manage your own emotions because you don't know the difference between your emotions and, you know, your friends' emotions. Like, when people call you with their stuff, you can watch something on TV and you just feel everything, and you don't have any defenses up because you haven't learned how to sharpen your tools. This is the time where spirit is learning, teaching you how to sharpen your tools, how to be an empath and be a resource to people, and not be an enabler, not be detrimental to your own wellness, because you are taking up to absorbing so much energy, and you're not reflecting, like, you're not, like, putting up a defense. Like, you as empaths, we have a responsibility. Like, all empaths are healers. Like, everybody's a healer in their own way, but all empaths are, like, intuitive healers. People come to you and they bring their stuff to you because you are a light, and they're attracted to your light. But you've put up this hard shell around you, like, you're not this giving and loving person because so many people have came and abused that light. But spirit is like, that is your gift. It can be a curse if you don't know how to use it, but it is your gift. This is how you're going to bless the world. This is how you're going to help people, because you can do that, but you also have to have boundaries set up. So this is the reason why spirit is taking you into isolation, to show you how to use your skills, because for one, you have to bring up all that trauma, all the trauma of the people who hurt you, all the trauma of the people who have overstepped their boundaries, or the lack of boundaries that you've had, like all the people who've just mistreated you because of you not having these boundaries up. Spirit was like, it's just a cycle. It's just life. It is what it is. Stop, boy. It is what it is. It's with the World card, like, shit come and shit go. It come in cycles. Like, you have to stop getting stuck in the summer. You gotta stop getting stuck in the winter. You gotta stop getting stuck in the fall. Like, it's cycles. You have to learn how to release with the cycles, release with wherever you are in that moment. Like, again, being present, being pulling yourself to the now, and not focusing on the past and not focusing too much on the future, but being in the present and being in the now. You said this season is boundaries and protection before the abundance. Heavy on that. Okay. Double tap, double tap, double tap. Heavy on that, because it's all about preparation, like all of that is just telling you that you need to be prepared, setting boundaries and protecting the asset of whatever that spirit is showing you. Like, spirit is gonna make you feel, when I say this is the, I don't see this being like a this next week, I don't see it being super easy. I feel like this week is gonna be very triggering to you. And when I say triggering, is because although you're in isolation doesn't necessarily mean just sit in your room in a closet for a week and don't go to the outside world. You still have to engage with the world. But when I say isolation, it's you being mindful of not retaliating to your emotions, you being secluded as possible, so not trying to intervene with, like, not going out on the scene, not being on social media, not trying to be around other energies. But say you still have to go to work and you still have to be around people, you still gotta go to the grocery store and things like that. This is a time where things can happen or people can communicate with you, and it's gonna get a little shady, it's gonna get a little offensive, because this is spirit like triggering your emotions so that you can see where are your triggers. What is a button that people are pushing? Lightning, please get down, son. Get down. Sit. This is you said this was you last week, honey. This was me this week. But this is this is spirit trying to, lightning, stop, sit down. This is a season for spirit to like trying to trigger you so that you can be aware of whatever your triggers are. Not in a way for you to retaliate with them, but again, if you're trying to get rid of your anger, you have to be presented with the opportunity to be angry, to say, how am I going to decide to retaliate to this? Am I going to decide to let it go and move in love and let their karma, you know, handle them? Or am I going to still pop off? Am I going to still, even if I don't pop off physically, am I still going to let it bother me for the rest of the day? Am I still going to be in a shitty mood for the rest of the day and take it out, you know, on my brother or something? Like, how are you still retaliating to your triggers? How are you retaliating to things annoying you? How are you retaliating to that? You're going to be presented with that, because spirit wants you to know. They don't need to know. Spirit already knows where you are, but they want to make you aware of what exactly is going on right now. What is it, the emotional what emotional processes do you need to go through to get to where it is that you're trying to be? Now on this other side, we have the Two of Wands in reverse, the Lover's card, the Three of Pentacles in reverse, and the Moon card. Now, the Moon card was originally upside down, and I flipped it. Spirit didn't tell me to flip it back, but it was originally in reverse as well. So, what I'm feeling with this is definitely a breakup. I'm not even gonna lie. I see this as being with somebody who you might have, I don't even feel like this has been like a long relationship, but it may be a long relationship, or you know, y'all been together for, you know, a little while, but you already knew this relationship was coming to an end. I see this being a time where you are loving more on yourself, and that's kind of the reason why the, like, it was originally upside down and now, I mean, in reverse, and now it's upright, or you know, I was called to flip it, because it was like there was a during all these, the time that you've been with this person, it's been you forcing it. Like, it's been you trying to literally reject the seasons, back to the seasons, and you allowing yourself to flow with the seasons. You've been trying to intentionally stopping the cycles from flowing, because you know that cycle has expired, and you're just like trying to make it stay here. You're trying to make it fit. You're trying to make it make sense, and it's still not making sense. But now we're in a season of truth. We just talked about that. We're in a season of truth. This Capricorn full moon is going to bring, and then it's the Moon card with the super, this super moon is going to bring out all the bullshit, y'all. It's going to bring out all the truth, all the lies, all the deceit, all the things that was not the truth. It could have been some truth or a trueness in it. It could have been, you know, something that was not a lie or intentional lie. It could have been intentional, but regardless of what, the truth is coming out. And this is the reason why it's like, okay, I see it for what it is, and now let me move on. I see this as being a time where you're also spending more time with self. This is also, this doesn't necessarily have to be a romantic relationship as well. This also could be a platonic relationship with friendships. You also are seeing the friendships that you thought you had, these so-called friendships, a lot of them are being exposed during this time as well. You're going to see what I'm talking about, these slick comments, the little pettiness, the cattiness or whatever. You're going to be seeing that in your so-called friends. Spirit is exposing anything in your environment right now that's not conducive to where you want to be. Everything that you want to, everywhere you want to go, anybody, the Two of Wands being in reverse, the people that are around you that are hindering you from moving forward, the people who are around you who are hindering you from seeing your vision, it could be people around you that you tell them that you have an idea about something and they always got to play devil's advocate. They always got to tell you, well, did you consider this? Or, you know, such and such tried that and this happened, but it's never something uplifting. It's never something that's, you know, positive. Like, hey, yeah, I did that. Yeah, such and such did that and they did great. They're successful. It's always got to be the negative story or something to fear you into staying on their level to stay compatible with them. Watch out for that. And again, Spirit is challenging you not to get angry, not to get upset, not to retaliate, but to just observe and be cautious and be aware of the things that you have surrounded yourself with, and slowly but surely, or swiftly, if you will, changing it to match where you're trying to go. So that's exactly what I was asked for. What I asked for, the truth, expose them all. Oh, baby, they're going to be exposed, okay? They're going to be exposed because the cosmos are in alignment with things being exposed. Like, the cosmos are in alignment with not only, for some of y'all, this is not just the outside world. This is also within yourself. This is the things that are exposed in yourself. Like, what made me sit around this person? Like, because I feel like somebody right now is like, once you see the shade, it's gonna be just so obvious. Everything that they do gonna be like, bitch, you been a hater. You been fucking like, you ain't never really liked me for real. You gonna start seeing all that, but you're gonna immediately, because we talking about accountability. We're not talking about pointing no fingers. We're not doing none of that. This is still growth, personal growth. You're going to simultaneously look yourself in the mirror and say, why didn't I see that before? What was stopping me from seeing this before? Because you're going to see the truth, which means that they've been doing this. They didn't just start doing this weekend. They're just going to see something. But the veil will be lifted on your eyes, that whatever was stopping you from seeing that in the first place. So then you get to check yourself and say, what about me didn't notice that? What parts of me was trying to avoid seeing that as the truth? Because they've been saying slick shit. They've been playing devil's advocate for everything, and you just been looking at it as, well, maybe they just want me to see things from all perspectives. Maybe they just want to see, they don't want me to get disappointed. Like, baby, I'm just the messenger, sis. I'm just the messenger. But that's what's going to happen right now. Like, Spirit is not just bringing things to your attention for you to just be like calling people out, like, oh, well, you been a fraud. Like, you been not like me, or you been cheating on me. Like, this is not what Spirit is doing. Spirit is wanting you to reflect on yourself and to see in yourself, what have you been accepting and why? Why were you in this relationship when you knew this person ain't really liked you? You knew they only called you because you a pothead and you like to smoke. And they only call you because when they ready to smoke because they ain't never got in on none. They always calling you to come to stuff, but they don't ever come to your house. Or they always come to your house and they ain't never inviting you over to theirs. You been seeing this shit. You been noticing this stuff, but you ain't never said nothing. So what about you was accepting that stuff? What about you felt like that was okay as a friend? to have somebody around you did that move like that. What about you was accepting of that? And why? Said my accountability allowed me to move on and truly evolve. Okay? That's the only way we can evolve. That's the only way we can evolve. This is why I say y'all have to take accountability for everything that's happened in your life. Whether you did it, whether somebody else did it directly or indirectly, you have to take accountability for everything that has ever gone wrong in your life. And right. Why? Because once you take accountability for it, you get to be free. Because you get to change the scenario. If you keep blaming your mom for how you, well, she never showed me, she ain't never been married, she ain't never showed me how to cater to no man, she told me, you know, you don't never trust no man for nothing, you always go out here and grind for yourself, like, how else was I supposed to know that I need to be submissive? How else was I supposed to know that I need to be kind? How else was I supposed to know that I need to learn how to follow? How else would I, until you look in the mirror and say, okay, mama ain't know no better. She saw grandma do it. She ain't have no example. My daddy wasn't around. He chose to leave. That's all she knew. She was surviving. Now, what can I do to change the narrative so my daughter don't have to go through the same thing? So my son don't have to see me struggling the same way? So I don't produce another fucked up little boy around here? What can I do to change this narrative? You said they'll certainly been falling lately. Okay. Everything is coming out and crystal clear. The only way that you can deny the truth is if you truly do not want to see. So you, the veil been dropped in your ass just like, okay, I still don't know what's the problem. I still don't know. Like, ain't nothing in front of you. And then you go put your hands in front of yourself to let it still be something there. Like, you literally just don't want to know. And that's okay too, if that's where you at. If that's where you're at, if you don't want to see the truth for what it is, you want to still be blissfully ignorant, that is okay too, because that's just where you are on your journey. But do us, everybody, a favor and stop complaining about where you're choosing to be. Stop complaining about not getting the benefits from the work that you have not done. Stop complaining from your situation not changing when nothing about you has changed. Stop complaining. That's the only thing I ask. Because you are literally choosing to be here. So stand 10 toes on your decision. Stand 10 toes on wanting to be in this chaotic relationship. Stand 10 toes on wanting to not be loved. Stand 10 toes on wanting to stay in poverty. Stand 10 toes on being a single parent. Stand 10 toes on it, because this is what you're choosing to be. This is where you're choosing to go. These are the decisions that you're choosing to make. Every single day, you decide to feed your flesh instead of feeding your spirit. Every single day, you watch a video and you take all the damn notes and you don't implement shit. Every single day, when that's what you're choosing to do. Facts. And you gotta accept it first. So, right, accept it for what it is and then move accordingly. You got to accept it first. This is where I am. This is where I am. I currently tolerate, because you can say what you want. We just had a meeting earlier this week in a Rebirth Society where I was saying, like, we did a growth assessment and where you wanted to be, where your increase wanted to be. Like, we just went through the assessment of, you know, everything in your life right now on a scale of 1 to 10, what it looked like in 3 months, where do you want it to be? We went through and we broke all of that down, right? You have to be able to, for one, accurately assess where you currently are. Don't believe what you say, believe what you do. Do not believe what you say, believe what you do. Don't say you don't like cheaters when you're still fucking with a cheater. Don't say you don't like being broke when you're still broke. Don't say you don't like being overweight when you're still overweight. Don't say you don't like not feeling pretty when you're still not doing anything to make yourself feel beautiful. Don't say you don't believe nothing that you say. Believe what you do, because your current environment is a direct reflection of your standards. If all you attract is backstabbing friends and lame ass niggas, that's your standard. If all of your exes are trash, that is your standard. If all of you ain't got no friends because everybody around you is a hater, that is your standard. And then once you accept that that's your standard, you also have to assess and accept that that's also you. That's also you. There's something about you that's attracting that. That's a you thing. It's not them. It's you. Because everybody not attracting that same. Everybody don't have that scenario. Everybody is not attracting losers. Everybody is not attracting, bum ass friends who hating on you and all the other stuff. Ain't nobody attracting all that. Everybody is not attracting that. I have dope ass women in my circle. Always have. Always will. As far as like close people to me, it didn't take me but like once to see that I had a snake around me and get fucked up, like have to get the karma from, going back to a friendship that I already had cut off. And I had to accept that nobody told me to even, that was my fault for backtracking when God had already closed the doors to something. That was my fault. But when you're looking at relationships and you don't like somebody for whatever reason, look at yourself and say, what part of me is shady like this? What part of me is not happy with myself? What part of me is fake confidence? Because when you walking around pointing a finger on everybody else, you got something to say about everybody else, but you can't look at yourself in the mirror. 10 times out of 10, you're the problem. You're the problem. Nobody else. So accept that, because until you accept it, there will be no change, because you don't see that there's a problem. You can't change something that you don't see if it's a problem. You think everything fine. If it ain't broke, you're not going to fix it. But once you find the leaky fence, the leaky faucet, then you can start plugging it up. So it's time to see and accept the spirit of people rather than the outward appearance. Facts. And the real tea is, the outside appearance is going to reflect the inside as well. Don't let that go over your head. We talk about like the vain girls and things like that, like the city girl type, the influencer look and things like that. But I know some girls that be dolled up to the T and have the most beautiful spirits ever. But it's not just about that. Like the outside appearance is going to reflect the inside, because It's the outside appearance is not just how you look. It's how you talk. How you talk about yourself. How you talk about the people around you. The people that are around you. How you dress. I don't have close friends that still eat McDonald's. I just don't. Because if you don't care about yourself in 2023... and you know me as a person, and it's not me judging you, because you can do whatever you want to. I mean, I am judging you because that's what we're here for. But it's not about me judging you to the point where I think I'm better than you. It's just that I can't trust you if you don't love yourself, how you treat yourself. You walking out here like your appearance don't matter. You got a bonnet on your head. You don't care to look like nothing when you walk out the door. We cannot go out together. We can't go out together because I think I'm a celebrity. So the people around me got to think they're a celebrity, because that's how you start attracting jealous spirits. I think I'm the shit. So if you don't think you the shit and you just walking around like, do you think this look good? Everybody around me needs to give big dick energy. Everybody around me. Because when you don't, you're going to have people around you who are envious of you. You're going to have people around you who just want to see if they can get a taste of this, or starting to actually try to become you. You got people who literally try to become you and do the shit that you do. When you have people around you who not on your level or better, I try to be the least fortunate person in the people I'm around. All of my friends got more money than me. All of my friends got more money than me. All of them are well more established than me. Every single last one of them. Always have been. I've always been like the brokest person out of my friend group, because I like to be around people who elevate me. And I know I ain't no hating ass person. Like, yes, let's get it. You can't intimidate me. I get inspired, okay? But I can't trust that with everybody else that's up under me, because I see how it is when people put me on a pedestal. I don't like that type of energy. I don't like for people to look at me and be all stargazed with me. Baby, it ain't never that deep. I'm just a regular, degular old girl. I don't want you to be impressed when you see me. Like, I want you to look at me and be either motivated or be like, okay, let's get it. Like, if like we equals. Like, but I don't want people around me who like look up to me in a way that just they feel like I'm on. Mm-mm. I don't even let my sisters do that to me. No, I don't. No, I'm a regular ass person. There's nothing that I'm doing that you can't do. Don't look at me like that. Don't look at me like that, because I know humans. It's not even about you. You might not even be that type of person, but I know humans. It naturally happens when you feel like you're around people and you don't have a pure spirit. And I don't mean pure like you might be evil or have ill intentions, but when you don't have a pure spirit, meaning that you don't have purpose and you don't know where you're going. You don't know what you want to do with your life. You don't have no direction. It's easy for negative spirits to catch on to you, like envy and fear and things like that, like jealousy and all that stuff. It's easy for those to start to develop in you when you don't have something that's driving you around people like in my circle. That's easy to happen. So it's not just about, you know, looking at people like, oh, you look cute, because a lot of y'all look cute and you still not cute because your energy is stank. The stuff that comes out of your mouth when you're talking about other women is vulgar. And I can never respect another woman talking down on another woman. I can never respect that. I just can't. I can't respect you. The only thing you talking about is niggas. Like, I can't. What else you got going on? What we got going on? Well, it's a time and place to fuck with the niggas. It's a time and a place for them. If we out and we out manhunting, that's a whole nother conversation. We out literally on like, okay, we ain't trying to pay for nothing today. Let's go out. Let's go look cute and have a good time. That's a whole nother different story. But we going out and we talk about business and stuff like that. And every 2 seconds, you talking about a dude. We not on the same frequency. And the outward is a reflection of the inward. It's a reflection of the inward. If your outward appearance, like, you just have to be validated. I can't be around women who always like trying to impress guys. Like, we don't impress niggas. I don't gotta try to anyways. Like, we don't do that. Like, you gotta have a certain confidence about yourself. You gotta have a certain aura about yourself, that big goddess energy, okay? To sit around me anyway. But whatever y'all expectations is for y'all friends, that's y'all expectations for y'all friends. But I know for me and mine, we on some healing stuff, okay? We out here trying to heal the community. We out here trying to level up each other. We out here encouraging each other. We out here praying together, okay? My friends and I, we pray together, okay? Get you one of those. Y'all praying and y'all in y'all word together, okay? How about that? Studying together. Y'all get some degrees together. Start some businesses together. That's women's empowerment. That's what we doing. And the outside reflects that, because you ain't gonna look like no bum on the outside when you moving like that. You ain't gonna look like you don't care about your day when you look like when you got purpose. You gonna represent God with your purpose, with your appearance. You're gonna represent something that's bigger than you. Your energy is gonna speak for itself, but your outward appearance matters. It definitely matters. And we got into a point where everybody who looks good, everybody who takes care of they take care of they have their mask on, literally. Their face is beat and the mask is covering up. But when you intuitive and when you can see people for the spirits that they are, you don't have to worry about that. Because I can see past that, them little lashes, baby. I can see that you still shady. I can see that you ain't really got no genuine heart. I can see that you don't really got no love in you. You got a lot of trauma that you're dealing with. I can see that. And I ain't gonna say I ain't gonna, you know, we can't have a conversation, but a friend? Nah. Said been cutting people out because we ain't got nothing to talk about. Okay. What is we talking about? When we ain't got nothing to talk about, that's a great indicator that you need to stop calling my phone. Or I just need to stop picking up. And you ain't gotta cut nobody off. No response is a response. Just stop answering the phone. Stop texting back. You talk about the same shit every day. Just stop responding. They'll get the picture. They'll get the picture. And if they don't, hey Barbara, this is Shirley. I'm just kidding, y'all. But let me go. Thank you guys for joining me tonight. I appreciate y'all. If y'all want y'all personal readings, if y'all need a personal readings, make sure that y'all go ahead and hit the Cash App before I get off live in like these next 2 seconds, because the discount is only valid while I'm live for only $22. But yeah, that's all we got for y'all tonight. I look forward to hearing from you guys next week. I hope that y'all do y'all fast and that y'all got some good stories to let me know. Or y'all can just go ahead and get in the Patreon. It's only $5.99. Get in the Patreon so y'all don't miss out this weekend, because we're going to be, you know, I'm going to be engaging in a group this weekend. That's the only platform that I'm going to be on, is in the Patreon. So yeah, let's get into it, you guys. Happy healing, everyone. And I will see you guys when I see y'all. Bye.